What is up, everyone? Welcome to the third episode of the UX Portfolio Series. As an ex-Googler, I'm going to share with you some secrets that I learned along the way when I was developing my UX design portfolio, which ends up getting me 5 internships in Silicon Valley. I'm really trying to keep my videos short and sweet this time, so let's turn up the music and play the title sequence. Good morning everyone, my name is Justin and I'm a designer working in Silicon Valley. In my last video, I went through a list of options of platforms that you can choose from to build your UX portfolio. I eventually chose to code my entire portfolio website from scratch because I want to maximize the creative control. Along that process, I discovered and learned a lot of things. And today, I'm going to share with you my 3 secrets to create better UX portfolio projects. 3 takeaways, 3 lessons, all distilled from my 7 years of portfolio development. Without further ado, let's dive right into it. Secret number 1, plan your content. With a given project, there's so many things, so many details going into it. For example, you have your problem statement, what problems your design is trying to solve, and then you will have some research or maybe some data. They are the reasons that back your problem up. Because you do this research, you found this problem, and that's why you're trying to design something to address those problems. And then for a typical UX project, you're probably gonna have some wireframes, you have some ideations, some mockup, some prototypes to showcase. After you finish a project, you have gathered all these things, these materials that you can play with, that you can decide what to show and what to not show. In a portfolio, you should present the most important things or the most relevant thing. To do that, you need to plan your content, plan your project before you put it on your portfolio. And here's how I do it. For each project, I create an artboard in Sketch. And I use Sketch to design, so everything is within the same platform, the same tool. So it's really easy to do. And then I will put all the photos that I want, for example, the text. Maybe I want a slideshow here. Or maybe I want to include some interactive elements in it, and I will lay everything out, what I want to include, what I want to show in the portfolio, lay them all out. Now, since everything is within the same view, same artboard, I really get a good big picture of how things will flow, how I would present my project. If this is what I want, then I will go ahead and hop into my code editor and code everything from scratch. By laying out everything in the file, planning everything, you really get a lot of benefits. For example, I can change the order of things in my artboard. I will change the order of this image and this paragraph, and then I can zoom out, and I will still get a high-level view, a big picture of how the project will flow, how that change might affect the flow. I can also preview my portfolio project really quickly to see how long my project will get, and how long, potentially, my audience will need to scroll. And you know, since we are designers, we get to really decide how to present our own projects. Nobody knows your projects better than you do. So you can totally control how it flows, what goes into the flow. Everything should be thought out. Everything is under your control. Design is not random. It's well planned. It's intentional. And also, you can create graphics right in Sketch. Let's say you want to present your research data in a chart, in a table, with some illustrations. Everything you can do right here and put it right into your project page, project artboard, and see what it looks like. Maybe it needs to be bigger, smaller, you can tweak it right there. Secret number 2, keep it consistent. Keep a format. If you notice, these 2 projects that I have, both have a very similar format, or maybe they're even the same format, which means I have a system for all projects. For example, I have a giant image up front, and then I have description, I have an intro paragraph. The benefit of this is quite obvious, actually. So one, it does save you a ton of time. You know you're gonna have one image there, you're gonna have one paragraph there, and then for the following projects, the subsequent projects you're gonna do, you know you're gonna have one image there, you're gonna have one paragraph there, you're gonna do that, you're gonna write it out, plug in there, done. You don't need to think about what actual information do you need, because you already know what you need because you have a system. The second thing is that when you have a system, a template for your project showcase, it really helps your audience when they read, when they go through your portfolio. For example, when a design manager looks at your portfolio, after they go through your first project, they hop onto the second one. If you already have a system, the hiring manager will have a sense of where to look for the information. They can expect, for example, there will be a giant image on top, and then there'll be an intro paragraph, and that's where they will look for the information, the high-level summary of your project, if they know what it is. At the end of the day, you want to make your portfolio super easy to browse, super easy to look at. When a hiring manager looks at it, they should be able to find what they need. By creating a template or system for your project showcase, you're really creating a common ground. You are giving the potential audience an anchor, something that they can hold on to. And that will make your portfolio a lot easier to read and browse. Secret number 3, celebrate the final design of your project. I cannot stress this enough. You have to reserve some space, maybe a lot of space, to showcase, to present your final design. Think of it as the marketing for an iPhone. What would that be for your project? The focus of your project is not going to be any of your rough mockups, your rough wireframes. It's going to be your polished final design. Imagine your final design will be launched publicly. It's going to go live. Everyone's going to see it. Or think of it as the final cut for your movie. It's going to be final, no more changes. That's going to go into the cinema. Everybody's going to see it like this. And of course, that's going to be the final version, the most iterated, the most perfect version of that movie. You're going to color grade it well. The sound is right. The sequence feels right. The sound effect is good. Character development is nice. So the level of polish for a movie, same for your design. That goes into your portfolio. And remember, I said celebrate your final design, not just show your final design, celebrate it. So think about using large, giant images, not just 480 by 360, but like maybe 1920 by 1080. Make it big, large. By using large photos, you're really forcing yourself to create a good image, because you can see a lot of details in it, and the details have to be good. Imagine your UI or UX design will be on a highway billboard or a screen for Times Square in New York City. What would the minimum quality standard be? And that will be your standard. And also, by celebrating your final design, use multiple images, okay? Not just one image, one shot to frame your final design, use multiple. Highlight the differences, highlight the details, because your app is probably not going to be just one feature. It's going to be multiple great features that solve users' problem. So celebrate them, use more images. Maybe use a context shot, somebody holding the phone, have an image in it, see what it looks like in that context. Or where would that person be using it? If you have a weather app, maybe people check their weather at home, so you have one shot of people holding the phone indoor. Maybe you have some great UI details or features that you want to call out. One example that I always give is to just look at Apple's iOS design. They want to call out their certain features in their latest iOS development. How do they do it? Right? They call this feature out, they have some write-up about it, maybe they have some animations. You can do the same, or you can develop your own way of showcase. And last note, a very important one. If your final design, the one that you're celebrating, is great, it's fantastic, look at the images, wow, so polished, so detailed, I totally get the message, you're probably just good with these images. You don't need exhaustive process to back up your design. Because think about it, if these final design images are so great, they can communicate a message so effectively, when I look at it, I see, oh, I can clearly see how this can solve my problem. I can clearly see that feature is useful. Then clearly, this is a great project. In that case, you do not need a lot of process to help explain your project. These 3 takeaways or lessons have helped me create so much better UX design projects in my portfolio, and of course, saved me a lot of time in the process. But I have to say, it took me a while to come to this conclusion. Since now you have the secret, it could really buy you some time in refining your portfolio. Now with these 3 takeaways, you're ready to take your portfolio to the next level. Plan out your projects, have a simple system to begin with to put your projects in and create more images for your final design. That's it for today. Thank you guys for watching. If you find this video useful and insightful, please go ahead and destroy the like button for the YouTube algorithm. This is still a small channel, so every like counts, and I will greatly appreciate it. If you want to see more UX design videos like this, also consider smash the subscribe button as well. Doing so will tremendously help the channel and motivate me to produce more high quality content down the road. Have fun following your passion and keep designing a better future.